What's up? What's happening, everyone? What's going on? Man, you guys wouldn't believe the adventure I've been on, okay? I've been on a very long journey, okay? A very long journey. They had increased my hours, like I told you guys in the last bit I made. The hour increase and stuff like that. And all, it's just been a brutal journey for me. And getting back to being able to drop some vids has been just like, it's been like a bonus, you know, treat myself type of thing. You know, it's good to be on here dropping a vid. So if you guys can forgive me, you know, I'd appreciate it. You guys know I'm a single dad, man. I work like the hours sometimes increase very, very drastically, and then sometimes they send me to locations where it's like combined of three and a half hours of travel time to get to and from work every day, and then dealing with the kids and helping with homework and all the other stuff I got going on in my life and everything. But I mean, everything's been going smooth, okay? I finally got to a location where the hours have been more generous. Like, I'm still on 10-hour... I'm still on some 10-hour shifts. They had me at 12, but they dropped me down to 10-hour shifts, which is not bad. Each job has their different hours that they work or whatnot, okay? But it's closer to home, so I get some of my life back. Yay, you know, yay. I get some of my life back so I can go back to doing some of the things I enjoy doing, okay? I know all of you guys all know about the homunculus stuff, man. A lot of you guys are like, what? Gam, you are super late. You like days late. No, I hopped on at the same time. I've been able to play the game and stuff, but I haven't been able to, like, hop on a vid and you know, reach out, you know. I've been watching some of the other YouTubers, Rafe, Childish, Nightly Gaming, Jew Bagel, Motivational Gamer, YDCB. Oh, grass, I'm so jelly of him. He got his homunculus already. I'm close to getting mine. Still got a little ways to go. I gotta get some water and some wind essence, and then it's more magic, but I'm hoping I can accumulate the magic essence as I'm getting the water and the wind, okay? And then we'll explain some things. We got a huge video coming up here, okay? Huge video, okay? One of the things I also wanted to point out was this thing right here. I know a lot of you guys come in here. I got a lot of guildies. They come in here and they get into to these boxes right here. And they're just popping these boxes like scrolls, okay? They're just popping them. And this right here, they have one for every single day. Like yesterday, I noticed that the water one was up. And when it first dropped, actually on Tuesday, the fire one was up. So, but this is basically for you to be able to open up secret dungeons. Like, if there's a specific secret dungeon that you need to do, that you want, okay, this is a way to get in there and get that SD that you want now, okay? You gotta get these washcloth type of things right here, okay? Garen Forest, oh, okay. So you don't have to go too far, but you gotta have a little bit of the essence going on and stuff. But actually, to be honest with you, this werewolf dungeon, I'm gonna be all inside of there because I've been trying to max skill my Juton and my Escher. Okay, I want them max skilled, and they don't like giving me werewolves for some reason. I guess they're like, oh, Gam's gonna try to build them. We don't want him trying to build that stuff. And then all this is nice, new decorations for once. Okay. I would like to have a lot of some bamboo stuff going on and everything. And that's 15,000 mana for that. So that's nice that it's something different, okay? Something different. You know, I got some palm trees over here or whatnot. A lot of these other things too. But one thing that kind of surprised me, I'm sitting here like, what? Not only do you have to get these crafting materials for the crystal dragon, but after you craft them, you have to still pay 500 red crystals. I thought you was probably going to have to just pay 500 red crystals, or you have the option to probably craft it. No, they want you to do both in order to get this puppy, okay? So, I guess I got some extra farming I got to do. That's no biggie, no problem. And then I like these statuette things and all. It's nice, man. They really stepped it up. And I'm working like a dog, okay, to get this stuff. I should be done with the water dungeon tonight. I'll be done with Wind Dungeon tomorrow, and hopefully by then, I'll do some extra farming wherever, okay? But hopefully by then, I should have enough magic essence, or I'm going to have to keep on farming, get that magic essence, okay? And hopefully I can produce more of the other ones until I'm able to get what I need so I can summon this guy. Still trying to figure out what I want to name him. I was thinking Darth Gam. Or no, not Darth Gam. Gambader, okay? Gambader. I was all inside of the chat talking about my Gambader is here tomorrow. Okay, I'm getting him tomorrow. Whatever. Yeah. Okay, and then another thing, these runes. Whoa, will we finally get that violent rune, that crit damage on slot 4, 6 star, with like 20 crit rate for Theomorphs? Will we finally get that, okay? But this is an extra opportunity. I like this because, you know, I have the option to try to make stuff happen now. It's like, okay, I've been farming Necro all day. They won't give me no will runes. Let's see if my luck will turn around in here, okay? So that's really, really nice. I really talked about that a lot when I was playing the light game. I was dropping a few vids for that. And there were so many things that they put in this update that they had on that game, and I was like, God, if they allowed you to craft runes in Summoner's War, oh, it would be bedlam. I would really be trying to do what I gotta do to get some more awesome runes. Okay, it'd be nice, but I mean, we'll see, because if it drops a flat stat, I'm gonna be like, what? I'm gonna be so heartbroken. Okay, I'm gonna be so heartbroken. Anywho. The Fire Dungeon, okay? I've seen a lot of guys. I think the highest one I saw Rapey's score. He had like 3 million and something. I'm like, hat is off to that guy. Because, like, wow. Wow. I struggled just to get this. And it's like a couple hundred away from 2 mil. And that was a far cry for me. I don't know. I'm sitting there like, wow. You know, I'm dumping everything I got into it. But one thing I noticed is that it is, you do want some AoE in there. I got Stella in there for her branding effect. Also, extra chance of defense break. I got Theo in there because he's just water, and that's my ace, my right-hand man, okay? He also does defense break. He procs a lot of violent. Zyros AoE attack moves, which is well needed in here, okay? And he has 2 AoE moves. You can use mons like Soha, and you can't say y'all ain't got no Soha. I was the last person to get Soha, okay? So I know everybody has a Soha, at least have Soha. Like, light, dark, water, and fire AoE monsters are a plus in here. They are bonuses, okay? Too bad I couldn't use 2 occult girls. Trust me, I tried, okay? I could use the wind one, but I don't want to use the wind one inside of a fire dungeon, okay? Not when I have other options. Rika has 2 AoE attack moves. Chaseun procs a lot of violent, but she can't hit the trip mines. Those trip mines, I noticed something as well, okay? And this is a heads up for people who are struggling. The RNG is not being in your favor, okay? Every time your monster has the opportunity, they're using a solo attack, and they still have, and they got like 2 AoE attacks on cool, that's already cooled down. I know a way around that, okay? I noticed this earlier, that you can actually pause the game, okay? You can actually pause it. So if RNG has been screwing you over the whole match, or it's like late in the match, real late in the match, and you know you're gonna die anyway, but you want to try to last as much as you can and get out that extra oomph, because the more damage you do, the more reward that you get, okay? If you want to get that extra oomph, you know you're close to death, this is an option, okay? This is an option. Hit this puppy, knock that stuff out, move forward, okay? I've noticed a few times that RNG would make them use single target attacks, and I'm like, I know for a fact that the Fury Blast is cooled down, okay? Fire Guardian Angel, it's cooled down. Why did you just use a teddy bear instead? And it's just like, okay. And then I was running Sigmoris for a while. Sigmoris was a good buff, but then I start running this. So I was like, okay, I like this team. This team right here got me my highest damage, which is close to 2 mil. And I'm like, I think I can actually crack the 2 mil area. It just all depends. Like right now, I'm not even getting my defense break. I don't have my branding effect, but we'll probably get him on the next groggy stage. There's the defense break, and then we have the attack buff as well. I had one earlier. My Theomars did like 50,000. Zyros did like, it's like 68,000. They were hitting pretty hard, but still, it just wasn't enough. All I recommend and what I suggest is just keep trying, you know, keep building it up, keep cycling through mons, keep trying different mons and stuff until you find the mon that, you know, that really helps benefit that team to getting that damage counter way up there, okay? It's like pinball almost, like it's like ding 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 ding, ding, and that score just keeps going up. So like, you'll get better at it. You know, when I first ran the Fire Dungeon, I think I got like 600-something thousand there. I had all sorts of healers in there thinking I'm doing something. Those trip mines went off and destroyed me. But then I got wise real fast, okay? All right, we're on a second groggy state. There's Glancing Hit, which nobody cares about that because he's groggy. He's tired. But we can use, there is a defense break. Can we get a branding? No branding. Right now, I'm actually in the water dungeon is the one I'm currently running right now. Oh, there's our branding. Oh, right when he wakes up, too. If we would have got that branding in the beginning, I probably would have been at like 1.3, 1.4 million damage already. All right. It's starting to get up to that late game stuff, see? Now, we're hoping for AoE. Ross, there we go. All right. Guy got hit with the trip mine. It was minute. Wasn't so bad. Okay, not too bad. We're still hitting pretty good. I was hoping that Bella Jewel inside of the Water Beast dungeon, I was hoping that he would, like, cleanse the because your HP gets frozen, okay? And the more your attack bar moves, people will say, they'll argue with me. I argue with a friend at work today, and he's like, no, it's timed. And I'm like, well, I feel that violent procs and attack bars is what moves it, okay? That's what gets your HP back, unless you send them into groggy state. If you send them into groggy state, you get to have your bars back. Whoa! You see that? And the whole team gets wiped, and it's because they didn't use the AoE, okay? That's what happens. But if the AoEs were all used up, you know, then there was no way out of that regardless anyway. But, I mean, that's that. That it happens, okay? It happens. This is the dungeon I'm running right now. I'm going to be running this dungeon next. This dungeon I saw Childish hit like, is like 2.7 mil. And he's in there with a Lich. I'm like, whoa, the Lich? No way. I'm like, wow, as many of them as I fed. Oh, man, all those lightning out of the legendary scrolls, all those Liches I got, and, like, I could have used the Lich. But I like seeing the different team comps people are bringing in here, and it's like, okay. And I was thinking, like, okay, hopefully I'm able to actually improve mine. I only ran this one a few times, and I ran this one just a few times. But I get better as I go, because this one used to be really, really low. This one used to be like 600 grand. Then finally I got it over a mil. Because I start playing, I start cycling out mons, and it's like, okay, this mon works better. This one works better. Okay, this one's helping getting that sky that score higher. So I've been running it like that. And then on this dungeon right here, speed, violent runes, okay? Speed and violent procs, I feel, has been the most success for me. Other people may argue, they may say, no, that doesn't matter. It's timed, okay? It's timed. And I'm like, okay. I mean, maybe it is. I mean, I don't know for sure, but in so far since I have been playing it, it kind of seems like it's going off of, look, watch, boom, boom, see, no, nothing's moving until one of my mons take a turn. Once one of my mons take a turn, it increases back. So if they start proccing lots of violent, it opens up a whole lot more. Like, watch, hopefully we'll see. Boom, 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 violent proc. See, it kind of moved just a hair. I don't know. I couldn't tell you. I don't know. The ice bars on the HP bar is what was killing me, okay? And I focused more on monsters that I knew that were at least fast or had violent runes. And all these mons have violent runes except for Stella, I believe. So, and that increased my damage. So, and I get to have my HP bars back a whole lot faster, okay? All these mons, I believe, are over 100. I think Ager's the slowest one. He's probably at like 130 something speed. And then Ritesh is in the 140s, I believe, like 149, and Chasun's in like close to 170s. Theo is like 160 something. Stella's like 180, I believe, and then Veligil, he's over 200. But as you can see, my monsters are they proc violent, okay? They proc a lot of violent, and they move those attack bars really far, okay? As you notice, we're pushing out the frozen bars. See how they're just pushing them out? Because I remember I didn't have Veligil in there. I didn't have Ager in there, you know, and it just seemed like half the time I was fighting just to stay alive. Okay, I'm just fighting to stay alive. Oh, if we can get a defense. Oh, it's nice. If we can get the attack buff, can we get blessed with an attack buff? Oh, nice. So we got the attack buff. Now we're really finna start rolling into some money right now. This is like hitting a jackpot. Oh, they cut it short. But yeah, that's when you hit the jackpot right there. When that branding effect, defense break, attack buff, that's the perfect little strategy combo right there. I've been learning that a whole lot more lately, and I've been more grateful to that. I paid a lot of attention to all these threads and YouTubers and people in chat when they were talking about all these combos and stuff and speed matters and all this other stuff. You know, I really play combo based, especially when it's like for arena. I'm thinking like, okay, what kind of combo can I do here? You know, what kind of good team comp can I pull off? And then when I'm in TOA, it's like, how can I make my team, every single team member on my team, complement each other, you know, and what can they do for the team or do for themselves, which also helps the team and stuff like that. And it's understanding your monsters, and it's having fun doing so. Okay, I have so much fun on this game. It's just like it makes me sick. I shouldn't be having so much fun on this game, okay? I shouldn't. But I've been waiting a long time for this raid. I nerfed. I completely nuked that event. I beat that event in like 2 days because I'm like, I don't want to be worried about the event. Even though it wouldn't even matter. I was just being Gam, okay? I was being Gambella, and yeah. Don't listen to me half the time, please. A lot of these other ones, this is the one I'm going to be running into next, and I got to build that up. I was telling everybody in guild chat, I'm like, Gam Vader is on the way. I was thinking about calling him Gam Vader, okay? Because you get to name him and stuff like that. You get to pick what different element, you know, you go to skill preview, there's the water one, there's the wind one, there's no light and dark one as of now, okay? No one said nothing about it and this stuff like that. But the one, I really want an overpowered water AoE mod, okay? And this guy, man, just some of the things that I've seen here is just like, wow, really? Are you serious? I like the sound of some of that. Which was one, and I think he attacks all enemies and decreases their attack bar by 30% with a 50% chance. That's not the one. This one right here attacks all enemies. Okay, so he's hitting them. It's AoE and absorbs their attack by bar, their attack bar by 30% with a 50% chance. Okay, absorbing it, which makes him even faster. Okay, so like, I don't know. There's different things that I was thinking about doing. I was really interested in it. I seen a lot of people doing the fire. Well, I saw YDCB do the fire. He's the only one I've saw with one so far yet, okay? I know a lot of you guys are ahead of me. I'm playing catch up here, okay? I'm playing catch up here, you know. I'll get there. Once I get my homunculus out of the way, Gambader, okay? Then I'll be able to do some of this other stuff that I want to enjoy. But this stuff ain't going nowhere, okay? It's not going nowhere. I'm not in no rush, okay? I'm not in no rush. I do want to get in that Werewolf Secret Dungeon. Ooh, look at that Werewolf Secret Dungeon. That's crazy. Anyhow, yeah. That's all I've been up to. That's what I'm doing. I'm just farming like crazy. Guild Battle should be starting here shortly. I need more energy. The Wind Dungeon, okay? I've been getting destroyed in here. I've been trying to find a team to come in here and do this. I've tried out different things. I even tried bringing Theo in once, and it was working out. But when he started getting hit, he was getting hit. And I was like, oh, man, I'm not going to be able to really use him like that in here, you know? Like, some of the different teams, you know, I've been trying. It's like, okay, some does more damage, some don't do so much damage. And then I'm trying to figure out how to get around, like, what is that electric move? What does that do again? Attacks all enemies 3 times with a furious roar. Electric shock. The damage increases every time the lightning roar is used. So I'm guessing that we're taking bonus damage. How to get out of it is the tough part. I'm gonna have to pull Darien back out. He's not really working out so well. I was thinking about putting Platy in here because I was running Platy in the fire dungeon for a while. She was actually helping out a whole lot. Plus she does some revive. She has a minute heal. But she's in there, but she doesn't have the violent, she doesn't have violent runes on right now. So I was just kind of like, yeah, I don't know, it's iffy, iffy. They're getting down. Man, It's good to be back on here, man. It's good to be on here chilling with you guys. I've been hearing about just a bunch of crazy stuff, man. Someone, people are trying to hack some of these guys, and like, I have a guildy. He got hacked. It was like last year sometime. He had an awesome account too. He had an Annabelle on there. He had Double Lucian and some other stuff, and he ended up getting hacked, and like. Claytona was talking about, like, once upon a time, you're all like, you know, maybe you were doing something that you weren't supposed to be doing, and he's like, no, man, I wasn't doing nothing, you know, I went to sign in one day, and I just couldn't sign in. It was telling me I had the wrong password, and this and that. I went to check the email, switch the email. To switch the password, my email was taken over, and this and that, and I'm just like, you know, that's jacked up, man, you know, so, it's jacked up, man. People need to just play the game. I mean, I know I'm not speaking in my own turn, you know, I'm just saying in general, man. This is supposed to be a pretty good community. Everyone needs to just enjoy things, okay? Enjoy the game, relax, I don't know. I just feel that that's just jacked up. And that's in my opinion, man. That's jacked up, you know. People work hard on their profiles and stuff, you know. People shouldn't have to go through that. I have so many 3-star rainbow mods, it's insane that they've given me. So now I'm just clocking fodder. You don't even have to give me no lightning. I don't even want any lightning. Just give me stuff so I can level some of this other stuff. I'd take a werewolf, okay? I'll take a werewolf. Okay? I'll take a werewolf anytime. yeah, same old, man. Same old. Lots of different stuff going on and this and that. HOH. This guy's not so bad, okay? But I have not been an Anubis fan. That's just me personally. I know people love their Anubises. I know the Dark Anubis is a monster. I got destroyed by one, okay? Yeah, I got destroyed by one. And it was just kind of like, wow. Okay. Maybe the Anubises got buffed. And then I built the water one. And then, like, I don't know. I just wasn't really feeling them. And then, like, just too much wind. Too many Lucians. Too many wind oracles and stuff like that going on to be trying to run him. You'd have to put him on will runes, you know, for better survivability. And it's just really tough. But, I mean, I feel he's worth it. If you have some good runes or if you want to really build him, he's worth it. He's worth it, okay? But, I mean, that's just my opinion. Anyways, while I'm sitting here knick-knacking around, I'm supposed to be in here working hard, okay? I'm supposed to be working hard. Trying to beat this old score if I can pull it off. You know, I haven't tried Katarina in here, but Katarina is not going to do the type of damage I want her to do because she doesn't... Chloe isn't gonna be where she needs to be in here, but I mean, who knows, I don't know, I might try her out later on or something. Come on, team. Clock that damage in there. Ooh, hurry up and take him out before the groggy state. I mean, before he gets to his max skill. That max skill is just insane-o. Dang, I wish we can get a defense break in that. Oh, nice! Can we get an attack buff, please? Please. Oh, it's already over. It's too late. Too little, too late. Alright, did your little ice move on us. Understandable. We'll just proc Violent up out of that. I don't know, I personally think that we have higher chances the more turns we take, the faster we move. We are able to get the freezing out of there, you know. Come on, team. There we go. He's in a groggy state. Can we get a branding effect? Oh, he's going to be damn near dead by the time we get a... There we go. There's a branding. There's defense break. The attack buff is up. Can we Come on. Pop a meal. Give me a meal. Oh, we hit a meal. Oh, nice. There we go. That's what I wanted right there. Uh-oh, here he comes. He's coming at us. We need to put him in his groggy state before... Here we go. We need to put him in his groggy state before he hits that max move, which I don't know. Maybe... I don't know. We'll see if we're able to pull it off. I mean, he's tankier than the last run, so... And he just froze us again. I believe he's going to hit his max move on this one. So, kind of what I'm thinking is possibly... I think he'll probably put Bernard in here. Kind of make his move faster. Maybe Bernard will push me right over that little bit of edge that I actually need. Not sure. Nope. I believe that's the max move or something right there. He did a dog walk move. Yeah. It's going insano now. Is he critting on me? So, yep, I'm just running that and running it and running it and running it. Now, I'm thinking if I take him out. Okay. Put in Bernard. What kind of leader skills do we got here? We got a Gambella leader skill. We have wind attack power, which the only one in here will benefit from that is Ritesh and Chaesoon, which neither of those. I mean, that's all right. I mean, I feel we can go for crit rate and hope that that can buff it up even more. I mean, I can take out Ritesh, put in... Sigmoris. Go with Sigmoris for the HP buff. But let's try Bernard and see what Bernard can do. What? He went before my Bernard? What? Okay, so it's looking like it might be the speed, you know? Or, I mean, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know, okay? I don't know. Gam don't know nothing. Alright, we're getting good hits in there. But this is the first round. This is the first round. We'll hurry up and send him into that groggy state. Ooh, wow, he's freezing people. Okay. Velajul is coming back. I wasn't expecting to freeze. Okay. Alright, groggy state. Can we get a branding, please? Oh, nope. We got defense buff. I mean, defense break. Oh, there's the branding. Oh, we got lucky. We should be hitting big time. Oh, can we clear? Oh! Oh, nice. Okay. So... possibly what I'm thinking here, I can probably take out Ritesh and put back in Velajul, okay? Do I have anybody that's wind that... Nope. It's only fire that I have that's full clean. Oh, well, the wind... The wind penguin... We can run him. You know, he has a cleanse as well. Oh my goodness, yeah. Some of these harmful effects, I'm brand new to some of these harmful effects. I'm usually running in all sorts of immunities all up in here. Like, I usually don't go nowhere without immunity. Immunity's like a big, big thing. Oh, got him in that groggy state. Can we get a branding? Please. There's defense break. Ugh, no branding. But we're hitting good damage, though. Oh, nice. So, wow, can we... Oh, nice. With the branding effect, I just beat the old score right now. All right, we're at 1.6 mil. Bernard did a huge buff for me. So, if I can deal with the freezing... Which I could probably put Vela Jewel back in, because then I don't have to deal with no harmful effects at all. And he cleanses. He doesn't just give you immunity, he cleanses. So, and he does pretty good in here. What? This is like a career high for me right now. Like, see, if we wasn't frozen, we'd be alright in life. Oh, he's jacking us up big time. Come on, team. Oh, he's trying to... He's hitting power moves on us right now. He's gearing up the Hemi on me. Will I make it at least 1.8? Can I get 1.8? Chaseon, heal him. Ah, it's over. Goodbye, Theo. Yeah, he's hitting his... Granddaddy Destroyer of Worlds move right there. Alright, that's a career high though. That's a career high. Alright, let's take out Ritesh. We'll put in Vela Jewel. Vela Jewel has the cleanse. And he has the sanctuary. So let's try and see if this works pretty good. If it doesn't, what I'm going to do is switch to the Penguin Knight, because Penguin Knight also has a leader skill. I believe it's an HP or defense leader. It's something like that, an HP or defense leader skill. Yes, I know what it is. I'm just not thinking right now because my mind is excited. I just beat my old score. We're actually booming now, making progress. Cycling mons to figure out what can get me that higher score, okay? So, huge attack bar increase going on, which that seems to get rid of the freezing effect. It seems like a whole lot faster from what I'm seeing here, you know, so I'm happy with that. Vela Jewel has a fire unit. He's taking massive beatdown, but we all right. All right, he's in a groggy state. Can we get a branding? There's defense break, attack buff. There's a branding. All right. Come on, team. Woo, 50,000 from Ager right there. You see that? Woo, Ager is getting down. All right, 646,000 damage. Looks like we're clocking it in right now. If I can hit the 2 million mark, I would be so excited. I'm going to be happy. I'm going to be very, very happy. I think I'm going to celebrate to a hot chili pepper. I've been eating the pepperoncinis. Oh man, I love pepperoncinis. The whole pepper ones though. Not the sliced ones, the whole pepper ones. Ooh, come on team. Make me proud. We have... This is like trying to beat, what's her name in TOA? See, my mind is just not thinking right now. The girl boss on floor 100, trying to beat her, trying to put in as much damage as you can before she puts up her sisters, her mimic mons or whatever. All right, give me branding. There's our branding. Give me defense break. Okay, there's defense break. Can we get the attack buff, please? There's the attack buff. Now let's unleash hell now. Unleash hell. There we go. 1.2 mil. Not doing too bad here. Not doing too bad. We are almost there. We're clocking it in. Can I pull 2 mil? Can we pull it in with a fire unit in there? Okay. Oh, there goes Bella Jewel. Okay, I'm expecting to get frozen like 5 times over right now. We lost Bella Jewel. Oh, here comes the freezing. See, Bella Jewel, he makes a huge difference, but when he goes down, it hurts. We're still clocking it in. If Chaseon can actually turn around and give us some health, we might be able to do something a little bit extra. Okay, 1.3 still. Come on, 1.4. Oh, it's not looking pretty. Oh, here he goes. His Destroyer of Worlds move. Ah. Alrighty, guys. I will catch you guys in the next video, okay? I got some little things I'm going to be doing. Trying to do some room farming and stuff like that. I'd appreciate it if you guys give me some feedback of what you guys think. Beast Dungeon Teams, okay? You know, you guys know the type of mods I have. Speak with me. Anywho, I will catch you guys in the next one.